Tutorial is going to show how to control video with Adobe Animate in HTML5 and how to make buttons go to different video clips. So what we're going to make is a web page like this. I've got closed. I can click on open and it opens the hand. I can click on thumb and it moves the thumb. I can click on finger and it moves the finger. I can click on any one of these buttons in any order. And it controls four video clips. So here we are in Adobe Animate. I'm going to create a new HTML5 canvas right here by double clicking on this. And in order to import video, you would think it'd be under import, and it used to be import video right there, but that's grayed out. This is leftover from Flash, which is no longer. So now instead of import video, we're going to go under Window, and we're going to open up the components, because inside of the components, you'll see that there is a video component, which is a container for video. So I'll drag this onto the stage. It's just an empty blank video component. And now I want to have my components parameters open as well. This is kind of your properties of the component. So I've got both windows open. Okay, so I can click now on the component parameters and I can decide what the source of the video will be for that video component. So I click on this little pencil tool and then go looking for my video by clicking the folder right here. My folder, I'm gonna click on closed that MP4 as my first video clip and I'll click okay. And I don't want to show controllers. I don't want the play and the stop and all that kind of stuff. May as well mute it. I don't know if there's sound or not, but I'm going to mute it. And then you want to give it an instance name. Everything should always have an instance name. So I'll call it closed. Great. Now I want to have a new blank keyframe with nothing in it and bring in the next clip and then another keyframe with nothing in it for the third clip and another keyframe with nothing in it for the fourth clip. So I'm just going to put the clips right in a row. And the reason why, I'm going to click on Command Enter right now just to show you that even though there's only one frame there, it will play the full video and just keep looping all in one frame. So in other words, you don't have to have a bunch of timeline frames to play the video. It plays it on a single frame. It basically says, bring in a video right now and just loop it. So if I make a new blank keyframe, not a keyframe, but a blank one, because if I just make a keyframe, it's going to bring in whatever is in the previous frame. I want it to be blank. Make a video component. Source it. So the first one was closed. This is going to be open. I don't want any controls. I'll mute it. And I'll give it an instance name of open. Do the same thing two more times. New blank keyframe. Video component. Source it. I went open and close. Now I'm going to have finger and thumb. So finger. Finger instance name. And the last one, new blank keyframe, insert blank keyframe, video component, source it, the thumb. I'll loop it, mute it, no controls. Call it thumb. Great, I now have four videos. Now, if I was to test this out right now, you wouldn't see anything because it would go, it would just play these four frames and keep looping back, and it would never have a chance to even play the videos because they would just go by them so fast. So it wouldn't work right now. I have to have stop actions to tell it to stop at that video frame and start playing it. So it has to stop there and play it. I'm trying to line these up a little bit better. It doesn't matter, whatever, they're close enough for this demo. I think I'm gonna call this layer right here, videos. Okay, so let's make stop actions immediately. So I'm going to close these component windows because I don't need those any longer. All the videos are in and ready to go. And under window, I'm gonna go to code snippets, open up my HTML5 timeline navigation and hit stop at frame one. Click the next frame and stop there as well. Click the next frame and stop there as well. And click the next frame and stop there as well. So I've got four stop actions, one on each frame. And the idea now is I just need to make a button go to each one of these frames and just stay there because it's got a stop action. And when you click another button, it'll just go to another frame and stay there with the stop action and play with the video that's there. So that's the approach. So let's make the four buttons that I want to use on a new layer. I'll call this layer buttons. And I could actually put them all on the very first keyframe and just leave them all in one layer. I don't have to divide them up into different layers. I could if I want, but in this case, because it's pretty simple operation, it seems to be able to read those buttons just fine, even though there's four of them all in one layer. So that works out okay. So I'll make my buttons by clicking on the oval tool, and maybe I'll just make a yellow button. In fact, I may as well just make all four of them right now. One, two, three, and four. And then I'll take some text and label them. So with my text tool with black text, I'm going to say closed. Open, thumb, and finger. So none of these are actually buttons yet. They're just kind of some graphics here at the moment. So let's turn these things into buttons. I'm going to draw a box around the first one, both the yellow oval and the text. So it selects it all. This is with my selector tool. And I'm going to say modify, convert to symbol. And I'm going to call it the closed B for close button. And it's a button. And make it OK and give it an instance name of the same thing. It's fine. You can make it whatever you want. But I'm going to call it closed B so I know what it is. Hit enter. Next button. This is the open button, so I select that by drawing a box around it. Convert to symbol. Open B. Instance name, open B. Next button. Convert to symbol. Thumb B, enter, and the last one. Convert to symbol. This is the finger, B, finger B instance. Now I've got four buttons. So the only thing I've made is four videos, four stop actions, and four buttons at frame one. Now I just want to code these buttons at frame one, code all the buttons at frame one, and just make these buttons go to different frames. So the close button, I want to stay here. at the very first frame. The very first frame, of course, is not actually frame one. Frame one is actually frame zero, because we're in HTML5 land, and that's what that is. So I'm going to go under the code snippets again, window code snippets. And while that button is selected, the close button, open up HTML5 and timeline and say, go to current frame and click to go to frame and stop. Which one do I want to go to? Not five. I want to go to zero. In other words, where it is right now. So it's going to go to zero and stop there. The next button, the open button, same deal, click to go to frame and stop. But this time I want it to go to frame one. Next button, click to go to frame and stop. I want it to go to frame two. Last button, click to go to frame and stop. And I want it to go to frame three. So it goes 0, 1, 2, 3. Those are for my four frames right here. And it'll activate each video. So all the buttons are coded at frame one. So frame one has a stop action right here. And then it's got the instructions for all four buttons. And then the only other actions are just other stop actions. So it doesn't go past those frames when it lands there until you click a button. So I'm going to hit Command Enter and see how this works. There it is, closed, open, thumb. Oh, I got thumb and finger wrong. Finger is going to be thumb. So those are backward. Easy to fix if those are backward. Let's go back to animate. This thumb button, go to my actions at frame one. My last two buttons, one went to three, the other went to two. I just need to reverse these numbers. Three and then two. Just reverse those. And that will fix them. Okay, thumb and finger. Open and closed. That's it. Done. Okay, works great. Now to publish it, File, Publish Settings. I'll call it Hand, perhaps. And click on wherever I want to put it. I want to select a destination here in the folder icon. And I will just, I'll put it in this, yeah, I'm just going to put it in this untitled folder here. That's fine. I want to loop it. That's fine. Include hidden layers. In other words, anything that has an eyeball turned off, it'll show those anyway. That's fine. It doesn't really matter if I check it. I may as well center it instead of putting it off to the corner like it likes to make it. I'll make it responsive, make the buttons work. I may as well scale it to fill the visible area, so it'll make it fit the whole window. Could include a preloader in case it takes a while to load up. And the main thing, you know, you can check these as you wish, but the main thing you want to do to publish this is export not as a texture, but you have to go to image assets. Really important that you do that. If you do not, it will not run from your desktop because there's a bunch of security stuff that's in your browsers these days that the only thing that's going to work is if these are image assets. It's just the way it is now. And that's it. And then you can hit publish. Just takes a second. And I'll hit OK. And now it will work on the net. And so inside my untitled folder, there's going to be an HTML called hand.html. I can click on that and everything will work. So that's about it.